Ladies and gentlemen, the road to Summerfest will begin here tonight live from Tucson, Arizona. What a King of the Ring we had as Jeff Hardy went through 31 other superstars to become King of the Ring, and his destiny was recognized.
Absolutely. Jeff Hardy defeated Dolph Ziggler from SmackDown in the final match, and I gotta say, it was an amazing moment for the Charismatic Enigma. Now he's getting The Miz at Summerfest in the main event for the WEDF Championship. Already confirmed as we're on the way to LA.
That's right, and Jeff Hardy's been waiting for months for this match.
You know, it all started, of course, a couple weeks ago when The Miz actually took out Jeff Hardy.
Sorry about this, but listen to the ovation.
I can't help but agree. These fans are electric.
It's a rock star environment here.
Forgive me for saying this, but I like this name better. Jeff Hardy and his creatures of the night in full force.
Extreme Enigma, the fans are on their feet. Jeff Hardy, he claims immortality.
He's on the cusp of it. He hasn't quite yet claimed immortality, Frank. I was talking to Jeff Hardy earlier before the show, and Jeff said he's not claiming immortality yet. He has to defeat The Miz before he does that. Sure, he won the King of the Ring, but the whole point of him winning King of the Ring was to prove that he could go the distance. And he's shown he can do it. He just now has to finish it off. He has to defeat The Miz in order to claim that immortality he's been searching.
And the reign of misery. Once and for all. Well, that reign of misery continued after The Miz defeated MVP at King of the Ring.
And that was also... Go ahead.
And ladies and gentlemen, we wish you a great holidays. We're back full force.
That's right. We're doing it big in 2013. You just see the confidence, though, in Jeff Hardy, Frank. You see he's reinvigorated, he's reborn, he's been resurrected, so to say.
When Jeff Hardy's motivated like this, I don't think anything could stop him. Not even The Miz. But we'll see about that.
Like he's saying right now, he gets stronger with every day. Every challenge that Jeff Hardy overcomes, every challenge... He wins. Every opponent he defeats, Jeff Hardy becomes stronger.
I mean, that really proved it when Jeff Hardy became much stronger when he beat the world's strongest monster, Mark Henry.
I still can't believe he actually managed to pull that off. And if I remember well, in this past season, that's actually Mark Henry's first loss in a singles match. So that definitely just shows you that Jeff Hardy has the skills to pay the bills, and he's talking like he can be the WEDF champion.
I think one man has heard enough of Jeff Hardy's words. Here comes the man who is the WEDF champion and holds the reign of misery here on Raw. Here comes The Miz. And look at this. Look at the way he's holding that WEDF championship. I thought we got rid of the spinner belt. Now he's holding it backwards. Look at that.
That's the thing about it. The Miz has absolutely no respect for anybody in the WEDF. There's a reason this man is the most hated man in all of WEDF. But that's also the reason he is the most dangerous man in WEDF. He knows everybody hates him. He doesn't care. He just goes out and he does what he wants to do, regardless of what anybody has to say about it. The man is absolutely despicable as the WEDF champion, and I'll go on the record right here to hope that Jeff Hardy finally puts an end to the reign of misery.
Well, don't we all hope that Jeff Hardy puts an end to the reign of misery?
We all do.
Dangerous, though. He proved it when he beat the MVP at King of the Ring. What?
Not just when he beat MVP at King of the Ring. You also noticed that he did a stunner. That reminds people, you know, I think that's kind of like Miz's way of saying, remember what I did at Rebellion? And I think we all did. Miz defeated Stone Cold Steve Austin in a title versus career match for the last man standing match for that WEDF title.
I remember these two battling in that Elimination Chamber Survival of the Fittest many years ago. These battles between these two have gone back a long time, and Miz has really just been the more successful one. Jeff Hardy, every time he's had that opportunity, he's let it go through right through his hands.
And you notice the disrespect Miz has given everybody, me and you and everybody else. He's saying he beat the system when everybody tried to hold him down. No, Miz, no. Nobody's tried to hold you down. They've just stepped up to your injustice. They're not going to take your bullshit.
Oh, come on now. Real strength and perseverance.
Yeah, real strength and perseverance.
Taking people out with cheap shots and hitting them from behind is strength and perseverance.
And whining and complaining every single week when you don't get your... Oh.
Remember, I have my restraining order, so he can't touch me anymore.
See what the anonymous Raw General Manager has to say.
Miz, Jeff Hardy, the two of you need to restrain yourselves, because I will not allow the main event of Summerfest to be canceled for any reason. Now, I've heard the cases you've made tonight, and there have been some interesting points throughout this heated debate. Therefore, since you two are eager to prove yourselves and show your true strength, I've decided to put you both in action tonight. The two of you need to stay sharp heading into Summerfest, so I've decided to see if you two can work together to keep each other on your A-game. That's why in tonight's main event, our King of the Ring, Jeff Hardy, and our WEDF Champion, The Miz, that's sarcasm by the way, will team up against R-Truth and John Cena. Good luck, gentlemen.
Whoa, what? That is going to be an interesting and volatile situation. I don't know what the anonymous Raw General Manager is thinking by putting two unstable teams together like this, but I can only say you have to tune into tonight's main event to see the fireworks.
I was shocked when I read that message.
I'm pretty sure everybody in the WEDF universe is.
Wait, how are these two teams going to get along tonight? There's no way, no chance in hell of that happening.
I think the real truth here, the test that the anonymous Raw General Manager is putting...
I mean, who would have thought that John Cena and R-Truth would actually be the same team? If there was one.
Now we have Samoa Joe backstage. Finally going to respond to Matt Eichhorn.
He'll have a point here. I mean, Joe's had a chance to put his hands on Eichhorn, but he hasn't done it. He wants to continue playing those mind games with Eichhorn.
You notice it every time, too. Every time Samoa Joe is in Matt Eichhorn's sight, Eichhorn immediately turns and heads for the hills. He doesn't want anything to do with Samoa Joe.
Nothing at all. But when the time comes, Eichhorn is going to get what's coming to him. Joe brings up karma. Carly is a you-know-what.
Revenge is a dish best served cold, as John Bradshaw Layfield found out at Rebellion. Matt Eichhorn, I hope you learn from your chairman's mistake. Because you're going to have to if you're going to get in a fight, get in a war with the Samoan submission machine. But anyway, we're on to our first match of the night, ladies and gentlemen. You all remember this man. He is the Scottish Nightmare, the Sinister Scotsman. Drew McIntyre, the Secretary of Foreign Affairs for Layfield Incorporated.
And Drew McIntyre set to face the United States Champion Christian. If McIntyre could pick up a victory, he could be right in the United States Championship hunt.
You know, I've seen Drew McIntyre throughout this whole season. There's been a lot of inconsistency with him. We know he's able to have the skills to pay the bills. You know he's had great matches with John Cena, Jeff Hardy, Ted DiBiase. He's done everything to, you know, put on a great performance and prove that he can be a main event.
He even took the fight for Randy Orton to the limit.
Absolutely. We cannot We cannot excuse that from Drew McIntyre. But what matters is results. And when you talk about results, you talk about our United States champion, Christian, who has gone into multiple multi-man matches with his back against the wall and has still walked out as the WEDF United States champion.
Christian has proved that he's been a fighting champion. I can't help but forget that I remember that the last time these two faced off, Christian was in the midst of that losing streak.
Absolutely. You saw Drew McIntyre did defeat Christian in that bout. But as it matters here and now, Frank Dog, Christian is on a roll.
Yes, right. It just seems like ever since he won the United States Championship at the United Championship Extreme Rules, it just really turned the career of Captain Charisma around.
Absolutely. He snapped that losing streak when he took that United States Championship off Matt Eichhorn in a triple threat tables, ladders, and chairs match with Shelton Benjamin. He proved he was the true champion when he beat Eichhorn and Benjamin again in a triple threat. And now he's sitting here trying to currently ward off the threat of Layfield Incorporated, who, as you know, its chairman is going back and forth. Just he's on a manhunt for the United States Championship.
He won a triple threat at King of the Ring as well. Very controversial win throw for Christian.
I wouldn't say it was controversial.
It was controversial in the way that Ted DiBiase was taken out.
Well, I mean, he still made it back to fight in the match as much as he could, but as it stands, Christian still did win the match, and I believe he pinned DiBiase with the spear, if I remember well.
That is correct, and JBL, JBL, you know, he's probably real irate about that. He wasn't pinned in that match at all.
Absolutely. So, of course, for JBL, I guess he's scouting tonight, but if Drew McIntyre can defeat Christian here, I believe JBL's Secretary of Foreign Affairs will make a big case for a United States Championship match.
See Christian, the veteran, knowing what McIntyre's capable of in this ring.
Christian never underestimates any opponent he goes against. He always has a game plan. He always has a way to win. But as we saw in the earlier season, he could never execute. Now, after being the United States champion, we see that Christian has finally started to lock it down and started to become the clutch player we saw him become when he became the World Heavyweight Champion last season.
And that's something that Drew McIntyre is the opposite of. He doesn't have a game plan going in. He thinks he can beat anyone, and then he turns around and blows it at the last chance.
Absolutely, and that's the mistake that Drew McIntyre has made. He has the talent, but he has to be able to execute. He has to be able to finish Christian off. When he gets the first opportunity to finish him, he can't sit around and he can't taunt. He has to finish it!
Oh, right to the arm right there. You know, that could prevent the kill switch or the spear, a move that Christian has adapted into his moveset as of late.
Let's not forget that it would be easier for Drew McIntyre to cinch in the future shock.
There's no doubt about that. It looks like McIntyre has listened to what I've said. He's got a game plan here. He's got to continue on that game plan, though, and not let his actions cost him here.
He's playing smart and going after the arms of Christian and keeping him grounded. The Sinister Scotsman is doing a great job in the opening minutes and now into the cover, only for a one count, though.
Continue to work on the arm.
Arm breaker right there from Drew McIntyre. Again, twisting at the arm and an elbow to the arm of Christian, trying to weaken the man, trying to work on those arms and make sure that Christian cannot fight back.
There's a power slam there in the cover. One, two, and no.
Not even close there as Drew McIntyre now continuing to fight back, but no Christian.
Christian fighting back, but oh man.
Whoa.
The strength and the power of the Sinister Scotsman.
Beautiful tilt-a-whirl backbreaker we just saw there from the Sinister Scotsman. The Secretary of Foreign Affairs could have a big win here tonight as he follows up with a hammerlock scoop slam. Again, continuing to work the arms of Christian.
And that's a scoop slam that usually targets the back, but the way McIntyre hit it, it also targeted the arms.
That doesn't feel good if you're Captain Charisma. McIntyre reversing the Irish whip into a power slam now.
Continuing pounding into Christian. Christian is out of it.
Drew McIntyre is putting on another star-making performance here. Consistencies like this will make Drew McIntyre into a future main eventer, but again, he has to finish the match. He has to get the win. That's all that matters when it's all said and done.
Christian with him. Oh, no. He went flat. This could be a hook to right this time. One, two, no. Christian again showing the heart of a champion, kicking out. But
there you go. Drew McIntyre staying right on the attack, not letting up for 1 second.
That's like taking a page out of JBL's playbook with the intensity of that clothesline.
Now McIntyre, what's he going for here?
Another power slam.
Nicely done. McIntyre looks like he's continuing to try to work the arms. Another power slam.
Work on the arm and back. Another cover. One, two, no.
Wow. I got to say, if Drew McIntyre continues this, he could actually earn that United States Championship match he could be looking for. But again, like I've been saying the whole match, he has to execute.
Christian fighting back here. Throwing no quit.
See, Drew McIntyre, that's the problem. You're leaving Christian with an opportunity to fight back. And once Christian starts fighting back, if he gets on a roll, you're in trouble.
That's an innovative move there by Christian. And here we go. Christian is feeling it.
Oh, what's Christian going for here?
Oh. Nicely done there. And now a neck breaker.
Following two impressive heel or calf kicks we saw there. Now Christian going up high. What is Captain Charisma thinking about?
Is he thinking of frog splash or drop kick or European uppercut?
Well, if he would have done the frog splash by now, he's waiting for McIntyre. Missile drop kick.
Will this be it? Christian, one, two, no. McIntyre kicking out.
Drew McIntyre quickly able to get the shoulder up, but Christian there again fighting back, but no McIntyre.
No Christian does counter there.
Showing great awareness, but Christian still one step ahead of Drew McIntyre.
Now Christian trying to continue feeding off his momentum. Nice sunset flip. One.
Cover.
Two.
Two. No. Textbook Christian right there. You saw he misses with the uppercut, though. Now this could be an opportunity for McIntyre to get back in this. No, Christian looked like he was reversing the Scott drop there, but the Edge-O-Matic.
Bristol-Matic, he calls it. 2-0. What a match these two are having.
Great match to open up Monday Night Raw. This is what you love to see on the number one syndicated programming show, what you want to call it, in WEDF today.
Uh-oh, I think Christian's about to finish it off. Does he enough have enough strength on that arm? He hit the switch. No.
No, he's not. Too early to flip the switch right now, but McIntyre getting back on the aggressive with a snap suplex. And now McIntyre.
He seizes the opportunity to maybe hit the future shock.
Is he going to get it? Kicks him in the gut.
Bucks
got the arms hooked. No, Christian, look at this.
Nice counter by Christian, and McIntyre going to the outside is, oh, look at this. Go to the man, cheap shot.
Like McIntyre wanted to take a breather. Christian didn't want to do it, and I understand why, but he fell into a trap there. Drew McIntyre was ready for it.
Hard Irish whip in the corner.
There you just see the intensity.
Oh, right back to the arm.
Ah! There you just see the intensity of the strong, predominant brawler in Drew McIntyre.
Right to the gut.
Gutbuster, as you would call it, Frank Dog. Very nicely done by Drew McIntyre into the cover.
Four to the face. Wait a minute, going for another future shot. Christian again countering.
Spins out of it, and now Christian with the running neck breaker.
I think
Christian favoring the ribs, but I think he thinks it's time to flip the switch. Is it?
No,
no it's not.
And
once again, and now the Scott drop.
Scott drop. cover. One, two, no.
I just remembered that that was called the Scott drop. Thank you, Matt Eichhorn. I'm surprised I would even say that.
Look at the arrogance of McIntyre. And now, oh, wait a minute. So two holds.
Club kick from Christian.
Christian sees the opportunity. Spear.
That's exactly what we were talking about, Frank. And now Christian into the cover. This is done.
Christian taking advantage of the opportunity and wins.
That was also nicely done by Christian there to use that spear. His shoulder was too weak for the kill switch. Drew McIntyre had it scouted. But when Drew McIntyre got too arrogant and flashed and, you know, he showed off, he ran over to Christian, who gave him that huge pendulum kick, and it followed up with the spear.
Even busting McIntyre open. Karma, karma.
Can't argue with that. Either way, Christian, that is why he is a veteran. That is why he is the United States champion. Christian knew his arm could, he knew he wouldn't be able to flip the switch here, so he had to do something. That pendulum kick hit, stunned McIntyre long enough. Next thing you know, spear, 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 but wait!
JBL from behind. What the clubbing, hell?
Clubbing Christian with a clothesline from hell, it looked like.
Clothesline from behind. Now JBL just putting off the assault here.
The chairman of Layfield Inc. going toe-to-toe with the United States champion himself, and now JBL with the clothesline from hell!
Chris was too weak to defend himself there, going through a tough contest with Drew McIntyre.
And look at JBL. Thinking he's doing a justice for us Americans with that.
I didn't know an American thing was attacking people from behind and backstabbing them like that.
Yeah, cold-hearted, cold-blooded, ruthless, and disrespectful at that. But be that as it may, JBL makes his mark on the WEDF United States Champion, showing that this thing between the two of them is far from over.
Oh, dear. Here we go again. Clear that R-Truth is in John Cena's head here.
Cena doesn't know what to do. You know, we heard him ever since the last Raw, Frank. We know he didn't mean any ill will towards Sting after that attack, but I think there's a lot of questions. And none of them really have clear answers, because I've seen the WEDF Universe all believe that John Cena has turned to the dark side. And so has R-Truth.
I think R-Truth has pretty much set this up, the way he's handled things. Cena didn't mean to hit Sting, I don't think. But we don't know. We don't know what Cena's intentions were. You know, he's been fed up with the whole thing Sting's had, and like, he has no words for R-Truth. He's walking away. Cena's walking away from R-Truth.
And see, R-Truth, he's crazy. He is really crazy, Frank Dog. I don't believe John Cena would attack Sting like that, but Truth's treating it as if John Cena's his best friend.
What has R-Truth done to really make that case?
I guess he's sort of broken John Cena mentally. Well, either way, another member of Layfield Inc. in action here tonight.
The legal counsel of Layfield Inc.
The legal advisor, the Harvard graduate, David Otunga. David,
he was the same man who organized that bounty on Mojo.
He organized the bounty. He organized the restraining order. He was very, very devious in his plans. But you know what?
And Otunga is one of the newest members here in Raw. He's been officially traded from ECCW to Raw.
Oh, joy.
But here's a man. I don't think David Otunga can put a restraining order on this man. Here comes the Moscow Mauler, Vladimir Kozlov, who has been on a roll ever since returning.
Well, not really, Frank Dog. Vladimir Kozlov has been having some great matches. There's no denying that, but on a roll, I find that hard to believe.
Well, you don't know about that. I mean, he's lost to really... You know how Christian was on that losing streak, but then he got on a roster winning that match. Maybe Kozlov will get on that roll.
No, see, that's the thing. Right now, Vladimir Kozlov was like Drew McIntyre. He's capable of having great matches with anybody. We saw he took Goldberg to his limit. But, you know, Vladimir Kozlov has to execute.
Oh! Otunga.
Oh!
Farming a bit too much.
See, David Otunga getting too confident in his first official match as a Raw superstar. Vladimir Kozlov with that headbutt says, welcome.
Vladimir Kozlov was drafted from ECCW to Raw in a supplemental draft earlier this year.
Now Kozlov. Otunga quickly getting out of his grasp, and now Otunga with the DDT.
And
a clothesline.
Those moves are just not phasing Kozlov. He's getting up right after Otunga hits those moves.
What is impressive, though, still about it, you can't take anything away from David Otunga's physique. He has the strength to knock down Kozlov, but maybe not for long as Kozlov just continuing to tear into David Otunga.
Otunga wanted to make an impression as first match on Raw officially. He's not doing a good job of it. But oh man! Doing a Samoa Joe-like maneuver there.
STO out of the corner. And David Otunga with a running STO, but there David Otunga getting too confident for his own good. Now Kozlov responding with that big boot.
He takes one boot, but hit with another. And oh man, look at this.
Exploder suplex into the cover for Kozlov. Two.
No.
I don't know how David Otunga got his shoulder up yet, but I mean, I have to say, Frank Dog, David Otunga, based on his EC.
Oh
my goodness!
Look at the elevation of that full Nelson slam.
I have to say, Frank Dog, based on everything I've seen in ECCW with David Otunga, I'm not sure Otunga is ready to really be competing with the best superstars on Monday Night Raw, but I mean, hey, at least he's not...
After he got clobbered by the likes of Wu-Tang Man.
But hey, you know, there is one thing going for David Otunga. He's in Layfield Inc, I guess.
Oh, man!
But...
Whoa!
I tell you what isn't going David Otunga's way. Check out what Vladimir Kozlov is about to do! Got him up, and sinks him down with the Iron Curtain!
One, two, and this is over. Good night, Otunga.
Vladimir Kozlov looking impressive in his first win back. That's a good way for Vladimir Kozlov to start the new year, Frank Dog, I have to say.
Oh, there's no doubt about that. Kozlov, I guess I can say now he's on a roll now.
Well, he could be on a roll, but let's remember this, ladies and gentlemen. He's been a relatively easy opponent in David A-List Otunga. I think a lot of people went in thinking Otunga had no shot when they saw Kozlov. And if Otunga really would have beat Kozlov, I think everybody would have been raising eyebrows at just exactly if really, you know, Vladimir Kozlov was ready to come back to the WEDF. But all those questions have been answered. All that doubt has been removed. Vladimir Kozlov stands tall tonight.
He's ready to make an impact. He demands more competition.
He is, as they would call, he is a Russian war machine. He demands competition. He feeds off it. David Otunga is nothing to him. He wants better challenges. And he might get them with an impressive win like that.
Imagine the TV champion in the United States Championship might be in his eyesight.
Anything is possible for Kozlov after a win like that, but we'll see how everything goes.
Anyway, we're scheduled for a backstage segment, interview with Booker T and Rob Van Dam. We've got a lot to talk about here. Remember, last time on Raw, the Dream Team actually won, but was reversed.
It was their win was reversed into a disqualification win for Booker T and Rob Van Dam. You see, Booker and Rob Van Dam also aren't happy with the result because they didn't really beat the Dream Team like they wanted to.
And Booker T is hyped.
Both of them are. They want the Dream Team again. They want to beat AJ Styles and Zack Starr and show them that they're not fucking around.
Oh, wait a minute. From behind. Typical Dream Team ambush.
And, of course, the Dream Team angry as ever. Oh, boy. Now we're going to hear more about how the anonymous Raw General Manager has tried to hold the Dream Team down and how the Dream Team didn't lose against Booker T and Rob Van Dam.
Here's a solution. Stop whining. Y'all got caught. End of
exactly.
Story.
They got caught with their hand in the cookie jar, and the anonymous Raw General Manager made it clear they're not going to take a win like that.
Speaking of arrogant, here comes the former United States Champion, Matt Eichhorn.
A million-dollar man, as many might call him, following his actions at Rebellion. This man is the chief of staff on Layfield Incorporated, one of JBL's most trusted allies as of recent memory. Matt Eichhorn made his impact at Rebellion when he finally did what no other man could do to Samoa Joe. He took him out and he collected $1 million in cold, hard cash.
I wonder what Matt Eichhorn's going to be doing with that money.
Who knows? Who cares? You know what Matt Eichhorn would do with that money. We both know him personally. He's probably spending it by the dollar instead of saving it. But he doesn't care. He has $1 million. We don't.
Well, I heard from the sources that he was trying to approach Eve Torres.
Whatever the case may be about that, Matt Eichhorn has got something to say, I'm being told from the back. You know, Matt Eichhorn has heard what Samoa Joe has had to say, and evidently Matt Eichhorn wants to offer a candid response live in living color in front of the people.
What did you just say? Eichhorn claims that Samoa Joe is afraid of him.
Are we in the Twilight Zone, Frank?
Uh-oh.
Well, there's somebody who might have something to say.
Here comes the world's largest athlete, the Big Show, who has a new lease on life, especially after he knocked out Chris Jericho. And, you know, Big Show has had enough of Jericho talking. I think maybe Matt Eichhorn might be on that list next.
We saw what happened at King of the Ring, ladies and gentlemen. Jericho lost to the Million Dollar Congregation in their rematch. And Jericho again snapped at the Big Show. Big Show finally decided he had enough of Jericho's shenanigans and laid him out with the WMD.
Look at the size of Big Show. Remember, this wants me to bring up the legendary battles Eichhorn and Big Show had last season.
Eichhorn and Big Show were the opponents for one another. In fact, Big Show defeated Matt Eichhorn to become television champion once before.
Big Show wanted a challenge.
Oh, look at Matt Eichhorn! He's trying to duck out of a fight. You see that, Frank?
That's all that, and then I've got a message to read.
I think I know what this is going to be about.
Hang on, Eichhorn. I believe Big Show has a point here. You want to prove that you're the toughest man here on the WEDF Raw roster? Well, I'm about to make this match official right now. So get a referee out here. This match is official, and Icon, you are not going anywhere.
Sucks to be you, Matt!
Nowhere to run, nowhere to hide.
But hey, his mouth might be writing a check that his million-dollar ass simply can't cash. You know, Matt Icorn did say he's not scared of anybody. Doesn't matter how big or how tall they are. And I like the Big Show for coming out and responding to that, saying, well, let's see what you got. Let's see if you can actually hold true to that.
And look at the size difference. Matt Icorn is no small man.
Neither is the Big Show, but...
Big Show makes Icorn look like a small child.
Matt Icorn, I gotta say, you know, Big Show is definitely twice that man's size, at least. He's at least 1.5 size times the size of Matt Icorn. And Matt Icorn is, of course, no small man by any means.
The punches don't seem to have any effect on Big Show.
Even someone as big and as strong as Matt Icorn is going to have trouble against the world's largest athlete.
Oh man, what a clothesline.
Big Show taking Matt Icorn down with that clothesline. And Big Show again clubbing into Matt Icorn with those vicious blows.
Oh man.
God, a skillet-sized head! The world's largest chop on Matt Icorn. That can't feel good for the un-Hawaiian Hawaiian.
A big headbutt. Matt Icorn is getting dominated here. I guess I can see why Icorn didn't want this match.
You shouldn't even see that, Frank. You shouldn't even see that. Matt Icorn simply called for the match. He made the challenge, and you know what happened? He's eating his words now, because look what the Big Show is doing to him.
Why not dominating him? Not Big Show with a knee.
It also doesn't help that Big Show is, you know, he feels like he's born again, and he feels like he can really be himself. You know, he feels free. He doesn't have Chris Jericho bothering him.
Oh!
Big Show! Oh my goodness!
That could be the opening Icorn needs, and now Icorn, look at the arrogance here.
Just tearing into a Big Show with those shin kicks. And now Icorn stepping back in the corner.
Oh,
the
man.
Big
oh.
Wrecking ball!
So, like a freight train. This could be the opening Matt Icorn needs. Drop kick.
Matt Icorn, again, though, you can't take anything away from his strength. You also can't take away anything from... Wait a minute. No, never mind. Right as it looked like Matt Icorn was getting on a roll, here comes the Big Show out of nowhere. Just tearing into the un-Hawaiian Hawaiian. I've got to imagine JBL has got to be really... I really can't imagine what's going through JBL's mind to see his chief of staff just getting completely pulverized and dominated like this.
No. Big Show is just flat out dominating my Icorn. Oh my goodness.
Of course, we also have to mention that Big Show...
Wait a minute, Big Show, what is he doing? Oh no! Oh! That's a huge mistake! That could be the opening Icorn needs. And
like,
look at his strength. He just scoop slammed him.
I think you do have. I can't argue with the theory that Big Show was going there. You think, you know, you go from the top. Wait a minute, Icorn into the cover.
Go for a big splash, squash Icorn, and win the match and go home. That's Big Show's strength there.
No, it's not. But it's a theory that still makes sense. I guess, but, you know, it didn't really work out because no reward, Matt Icorn able to get out of the way.
High risk, high reward is what they call it. And oh no, another one! Another splat in the corner.
Ouch!
Is Icorn going to do this? Can he hit this on Big Show?
What's he going for?
Looks like he's going for the Un-Hawaiian Nightmare, and Big Show not having any of it.
Big Show able to slip out of Eichhorn's grasp.
Or the kill shot. Cover now, one, two, no. And now, oh, what a bicycle kick by Eichhorn. Cover now, will this be it? Two, no.
Wow. Matt Eichhorn taking a Big Show down with that impressive bicycle kick. He can't take anything away from his athleticism.
Oh, it's fear. Fear by the Big Show. The crowd is on their feet. Can Big Show finish off Eichhorn? Go for the cover, no. He's going to finish him off with the WMD. He's loading it up. Is it time for the WMD? No, it's a choke slam. No, what a counter.
Wow. Matt Eichhorn out of nowhere with that beautiful counter to the choke slam.
That was amazing. Now Eichhorn, oh, what a clothesline.
Jesus.
This has been a hard-hitting matchup here. Tell you what, though, I didn't think this was going to be good from the get-go, but it's actually turned into pretty decent.
It is now that Matt Eichhorn has finally started to take the Big Show seriously, and Jesus goodness! Look at the strength with that Samoan drop!
Two, no!
Ladies and gentlemen, these are two heavy hitters going at it in the middle of the ring that you can't take anything away from them. This is absolutely incredible what we're seeing.
Those shin kicks. Uh-oh, I think Big Show is feeling it. I think he's getting that, he's pumped. Can't think of the word.
Big Show is hyped up. Big Show running on pure adrenaline. Oh my goodness.
What a headbutt.
Oh, now Big Show, look at him. Feel it with those clotheslines. Ouch.
Oh my goodness. What a cross body. One, two, no.
And wait a minute, Show! The Showstopper!
This could be it. Wait a minute, what is this? Oh no.
It's Chris Jericho! What's he doing here?
What the hell is Jericho doing out here?
Look at him, he's yelling at Big Show, calling him a stupid knucklehead, and he's distracting him, but Big Show doesn't know what to do! And the referee's trying to tell Jericho to get out of here, but nothing's working, and now look at Eichhorn!
Oh, Corbin blow from behind.
And now, Eichhorn with the kill shot!
Do this! Oh, he did it! He hit the kill shot on Big Show! One, two, three, this is it!
Wow. You know, I'd be more impressed with that victory if Matt Eichhorn won legitimately, but I gotta say here, I really don't like the fact that Chris Jericho came in and ruined such a great match, and now that's tarnished Matt Eichhorn's victory, but you know what?
Eichhorn doesn't care. He's regardless, and he's gonna be bragging about it the next time I'm wrong.
And that's the thing I'm about to say here, Frank. If Matt Eichhorn really thinks he won here, if he really thinks he beat the Big Show legitimately, he didn't do any of that. We clearly see that Big Show was distracted, and Eichhorn just took advantage of it. That's not winning. That's not... How do you call that a fair victory?
I don't call it a fair victory.
Matt Eichhorn will. You know he will. We both know he's going to say a win's a win. And we're going to sit here and tell him, no, it's not. Because you had help. You didn't beat the Big Show. You
well,
made
Eichhorn,
the big challenge.
Eichhorn's going to think our opinion is irrelevant. So
I don't care what he thinks. Because the WEDF Universe is going to agree with us. And no matter what Matt Eichhorn says, he can
He doesn't give a shit about the WEDF Universe, though.
He can never overrule the majority, though. And the main thing here is that Matt Eichhorn did not defeat the Big Show cleanly, but he did pick up the win.
Oh, look at this Christian here. Christian says he's not hard to find.
Responding to JBL's ambush, he's saying, I'm going to do the American thing and I'll fight with honor and dignity, something you don't have. You want me for the United States Championship? I'm right here. Let's go.
Simple as that. I tell you what, we're about to have another match here. Someone's already in the ring, and he's about to face someone who's hungry tonight.
We don't know who it is. No, we're just kidding. We know who it is, but oh boy,
Curt Hawkins.
Yikes!
You know he didn't get the job done against Zack Ryder. There's no chance he's gonna get the job done against whoever. Oh boy.
You talk about hungry. Here comes Big Hungry himself. Ryback.
And he's hungry for a feast tonight. I don't want to be Curt Hawkins in that ring tonight.
You know something? I gotta say, Frank, after seeing what Ryback has been capable of doing, Curt Hawkins, thanks for coming.
He won a 2-on-1 handicap match against the Job Squad on the Pat United. Dominated everyone else who's been in his path.
He has been making waves in the WEDF. I can see the WEDF universe is excited to see Ryback in WEDF. And why wouldn't they be? The man is tremendous. His strength is unparalleled. But Ryback has yet to find a home yet. I know he's just going around the WEDF, facing any and all comers before he gets situated on the new brand, wherever he may end up. If I remember well, of course.
That is correct. Ryback still hasn't been on a brand yet. Look at that boot. Look at Curt Hawkins. He's trying to run away.
I don't think Curt Hawkins wants any of this, and I don't think anybody can blame him, but at the same time, I think everybody would commend Curt Hawkins a little more for at least trying to put up a fight against Ryback.
Well, he's trying now. He's in survival mode.
Trying to survive Big Hungry, but Ryback not going down easy. Big snap suplex from Ryback. And oh my goodness, the strength!
A sidewalk slam. Days of Batista or Abyss who are known to hit those moves like that.
And Wade Barrett.
And another one.
Jesus! Curt Hawkins, I really don't know what to say because...
And oh my goodness!
Ryback with that big meat hook. You know what he's saying? He's saying, finish it! Curt Hawkins on Dream Street, and now Ryback lifting the man up.
Shell shot.
Boom!
Cover, this is it. One, two, we got a kick out. No, we got three.
If only we did have a kick out. Either way, Big Hungry Ryback claims another victim. Curt Hawkins, thanks for coming. Ryback continues his impressive role. The man is still undefeated in WEDF. Just imagine if he lands on Monday Night Raw, Frank. And you know Monday Night Raw is already a land of walking giants. Imagine throwing Ryback in the mix.
That would be crazy.
And the potential for Ryback in WEDF is amazing, especially on Monday Night Raw, considering the talents we have. Kozlov, Goldberg, Mark Henry, Ezekiel Jackson, John Cena,
Bobby Lashley,
Triple H, name after name after name, can all face Ryback, and they would all be intense matches.
What about these two men?
Speaking of Mark Henry and Ezekiel Jackson,
Henry is pissed off.
As I think Mark Henry should be. You know, Jeff Hardy got him. And Mark Henry, though, I think he feels like he got robbed. But here's somebody who might have something to say to them. Oh, buddy.
Oh.
And don't forget, Goldberg still has business to settle with the Hall of Pain.
Things are getting intense back here.
Oh, Frank. To quote the legendary Jim Ross, business is about to pick up here.
Oh, man. And there's unfinished business between these two. Henry warning Goldberg here. He's going to put him in the Hall of Pain again. And there's no Kane to back him up. Wait a minute.
There's somebody who might have something to help say about it. Remember, Bobby Lashley and Goldberg once affiliated.
Once enemies now, it looks like they put the pack behind them and don't know what they're saying here.
I think things are about to get ready in Goldberg and Lashley. I think they're getting ready for a fight. Oh, no, they're not. Never mind. Lashley coming in to make the assist for Goldberg.
Uh-oh. It's Triple H. You know, Bobby Lashley has a tremendous history with him. You know what happened, King of the Ring.
This could lead to a very interesting situation by next week, Frank Dog.
Well, there's no doubt about that. Tell you what, Summerfest is going to be superb. We got the WWE Championship match. It's already set. The Miz takes on the challenger, Jeff Hardy.
And hey, let's show some love to SmackDown. CM Punk versus Shawn Michaels in a huge World Heavyweight Championship match.
And don't forget on ECCW, this is a long time coming. Wade Barrett versus William Regal for the ECCW Championship.
Already, Summerfest is looking to be the event of the season. But in any case, it's time for our main event, ladies and gentlemen. Out coming to the ring, the number one contender, the King of the Ring, the charismatic enigma, the legend thriller, Jeff Hardy.
The fans still on their feet for the charismatic enigma, Jeff Hardy. And here's the question I've got to ask you. How are these two going to get along? We saw what happened between John Cena and R-Truth backstage. John Cena wants no part of R-Truth. And The Miz and Jeff Hardy, you know their history. The Miz forgot Jeff Hardy.
Well, like the anonymous world general manager said, like I was going to try to say earlier, I could see why he put this match together. He thinks by putting two enemies together, they're going to have to work together, and they're only going to bring the best out of each other. They're going to make sure that they're on their A-game and they stay sharp heading into Summerfest, because I would tell you that either Jeff Hardy or The Miz, if one of them lost here tonight, one of them would be sorely disappointed in their match at Summerfest if they couldn't pick up the win here tonight.
And here comes our WEDF champion, The Miz.
Again, the most hated man in WEDF.
The most hated champion in the WEDF. Not the the most hated champion.
You know what, Miz rocks it well. As much as you hate him, as much as I hate him, I have to say, Miz has walked in with reckless abandon, and he's shown he really doesn't care if people love him or hate him. He's just going to do what he wants to do, and regardless of us sitting here saying, you know, we don't like what he does, we could be broken records and say the same things and rant every week. We don't have to explain how sick The Miz has been over the past few weeks. But we don't condone it, we don't accept it, and we're not going to sit here and ruin our wrestling program for this man each and every week. I refuse to sit here and waste my time ranting on him knowing that he's not going to change. I just hope Jeff Hardy does the right thing and beats The Miz.
I hope so too. But tonight they're partners, and here comes John Cena, who's been known for controversy over the past many episodes of Raw.
You know, Frank, I'm realizing something very strange right now. If the fans believe John Cena has turned to the dark side, why are they giving him a standing ovation?
I don't know. Maybe they like the side of Cena.
I think everybody likes to see a human element in John Cena. And I gotta say, you know, I'd love to see it, but the things John Cena has been able to do, they're super heroic, and I don't know what to say. I liked Cena before this, but I don't know if they should be cheering him. I don't know if they cheer for the dark side of John Cena. If it was really Cena being, you know, as evil as he says, because look at who he's associated with.
Coming out to a court of booze. Here goes all R-Truth, and look at how he's coming out here.
R-Truth just dancing and being arrogant. Telling everybody off. Bragging about how he's teaming up with the real John Cena. You can see the smirk on his face. He really thinks John Cena is on his side.
I tell you, one person that probably on his side of the heartbeat, that would be The Miz. Imagine if these two were to join forces.
Oh, Jesus. Let's not and say we did. Either way, Frank, I think I might now have a reason why the fans were cheering John Cena. You know, I shouldn't think that they're supporting John Cena turning to the dark side. I should think Tucson, Arizona is trying to tell Cena to hang in there. Things will work out. Things will clear up. John Cena will prevail. He will overcome. He is a human. He has a problem in front of him. Things look bleak. But they know, Tucson, Arizona knows, and the WEDF universe knows that John Cena will work to overcome these problems. But so far, it doesn't look good for him.
Not at all. But you know Cena, he's won to overcome the odds, the obstacles, many times before. R-Truth, what's he doing?
He dropped off the apron when Jeff Hardy was about to hit him. By accident. Now Cena and Hardy with the stare down in the ring.
Jeff Hardy and John Cena, two of the biggest faces of this company.
Two of the biggest faces on the Monday Night Raw brand. But I see a lot of people are pro Hardy here tonight, rooting for that underdog to defeat John Cena here tonight.
Tell you what, John Cena might have, you don't say this often, he might have the grappling edge over Jeff Hardy.
John Cena is the more experienced wrestler, so to say. You know, Jeff Hardy has been known to really just be a daredevil. Use his aerodynamics. Go high risk, go high reward, and use his speed to his advantage. Cena, on the other hand, has been mainly a brawler. He's also a grappler. He's shown he can go toe-to-toe with some of the best technical wrestlers in the game.
So far, so good in this tag match. We haven't seen the who. Which part are you worried more about, The Miz or R-Truth?
I have no idea. I'm worried about everybody because, you know, this is a match that could really go one of two ways. Either this is going to end smoothly for one team, or both teams are just going to go at it, and it's going to be hell broken loose, and we're not going to have a true finish to this main event. But I think that's what everybody's tuning in to see. I think everybody's going to see if there's going to be fireworks spread. I think everybody just wants to see. Oh, look at this!
John Cena was having momentum over Jeff Hardy, but R-Truth tags himself in.
And Cena is not walking into this match in, you know, the clearest mental state. He is, you know, confused over his actions with Sting. He's frustrated at R-Truth. He doesn't really know where to stand right now. But I think the WEDF fans are hopeful that John Cena can figure this out, because they certainly can't.
Look at The Miz and R-Truth going at it. This is something interesting.
The WEDF champion going against someone in R-Truth who I believe has, wait a minute, covered by Miz. One!
Just a kick out there.
Truth able to get the shoulder up, and I believe, in my opinion, Truth has elevated himself recently. And this past season, you know, he had that successful reign as ECCW champion. Right before then, he was going nowhere on SmackDown and on Raw, no matter where he went. Then he went over to ECCW, got that spark back in his career as the ECCW champion.
What really got his spark back was when he was eliminated in a battle royal to determine the next number one contender for the low-class television championship at that time, but which was, and R2 saw his career as rock bottom. He's like, if I can't win the TV championship with this attitude, I've got to change things up.
And the other thing about it, though, Frank,
is there was like a conspiracy holding him down at that time.
There's also one other key element about this, Frank, is that R-Truth on Raw recently, he's done something I don't think many men can do. He's beaten John Cena physically and mentally so far.
John Cena actually working together with R-Truth.
I'm surprised. That right there might have some people questioning.
R-Truth, oh! We got R-Truth wanted to tag in John Cena for a double team maneuver on Jeff Hardy.
I don't think Cena trusts Truth.
Wait a minute. Oh! Nearly hitting Cena.
Oh! Jesus goodness!
R-Truth wanted to work together with his so-called buddy, John Cena.
Yeah, I think that's just as that's confusing to everybody here, Frank. You know, Cena looked like he was willing to work with Truth. Then the next minute, he doesn't want to work with him. I think even John Cena doesn't know what he's doing.
And it looks like The Miz and Jeff Hardy have put their differences aside for one night. Maybe they're trying to outdo each other.
Who knows, but either way, look at that from The Miz!
What is Miz thinking here? Oh! Hanging up R-Truth on the ropes, and R-Truth is in trouble here.
Hot shot coming from The Miz!
Two! No.
I'm just still silent, though, Frank. I'm very confused as to what's going on here.
I don't know either. Now, Jeff Hardy blind tagging Miz in. Miz thinks he's still the partner here. Miz realizing the tag was made and escaped.
I don't know if it was more of that, because to me it looked like more of Jeff Hardy making the tag when Miz was dragging him over to the corner, making the conscious, you know, save, sort of. If you could say that.
What is Jeff Hardy doing here? So far this match is, I don't know what to say, it's just really no fault here.
I think everybody is just waiting for the fireworks, Frank. Because right now, things are going really quietly.
And the Miz throwing R-Truth back in the ring. Remember, R-Truth is busted open. John Cena's doing nothing. One, two, and John Cena's now breaking it up. Showing the sign of doing the right thing, as he would say.
At least there it was, you know, and that's the thing about it. If John Cena really disliked R-Truth this much, why would he go in to make the save?
Jeff Hardy wants to tag in Miz. What is Miz doing? Going up high.
I think Miz is saying tag me in when Jeff Hardy's trying to go up high in the distraction.
It looked like Jeff Hardy was wanting to hit the Swanton Bomb, and Miz was distracting Hardy. And now R-Truth gained the momentum. This weird tag match is continuing. And now John Cena's in. R-Truth tagging Cena in.
John Cena, like a house of fire, I guess. I don't know.
Cena is feeling it. This is the main event of Raw. Now John Cena, look at this.
Got him up. Jesus.
That proto bomb.
Absolutely.
Uh-oh.
Beautifully done by Cena. Oh, Frank, you know what he could be sent for up after that proto bomb.
Here we go. Five Jocko Shuffle. Boom. I think Cena's going to finish off Jeff Hardy here. R-Truth is trying to get John Cena's face here. And now R-Truth is in the ring.
What is this all about?
Just slapped Cena.
Oh, wait a minute. Cena's had enough.
Look at this. Cena got him up.
Attitude adjustment.
Boom.
There's the fireworks we were talking about. Look at him go! Cena throwing truth to the outside! But the distraction pays off! Jeff Hardy with the twist of fate!
I think Jeff Hardy's gonna set for the Swanton now. Here we go. Can Hardy do this?
No!
What?
Miz tags himself in! And now look! Skull crushing finale! Miz is taking the credit for himself!
Oh, come on now. No, not this way. Three, this is it.
This was a very strange tag match. I don't even think we could call this a tag match. This was a spectacle. I don't even know what to say here. Jeff Hardy and The Miz win, but...
And look at them, they're trying to show off each other by celebrating.
I don't know what's going on here, Frank. Either way, John Cena finally had enough of R-Truth, and...
Awesome.
This situation is only going to get messier.
Good night from WEDF.